War for the Planet of the Apes is directed by Matt Reeves and written by Matt Reeves and Mark Baumbach, and it stars once more Andy Serkis and Woody Harrelson, among a few others. And this is the third and final installment into the new Planet of the Apes trilogy. It's been 5 years since Dawn, since Gary Oldman and his crew sent out a distress signal into the army, and now Woody Harrelson has come in full force to take the apes out. The apes are looking for somewhere to run away, a new place to live in peace, but the humans are relentless after them. And after this war rages on, after unimaginable losses for the apes, Caesar wrestles with his darker instincts and begins his own quest to avenge the apes. I'm a huge fan of the Planet of the Apes movies most recently. Rise is a great movie. Dawn is a movie that I adore to death. And now, Matt Reeves, with this third movie, has made my fourth favorite trilogy of all time. This movie takes you on a harrowing journey, and it asks you to go with characters to places that you will not feel comfortable with, because the allegories of this narrative are all in your face, and I mean this in a good way. This is as classic as a narrative can be, not only within this trilogy of Planet of the Apes movies, but just everything that has been about these movies, just everything that the message of these movies should be. This story takes so many turns that you are not expecting. This movie goes to places that I did not think it would go. From simple things just as the visual locations that it is set on, how dark it becomes after that, how many characters it deals with, how it deals with those characters. Caesar in this movie becomes one of my favorite heroes in film history. He goes down a dark path in this movie, and it is as poetic as it can be. If you look back and see how this ape started, if you see what type of a leader he became in Dawn, and in this movie, Caesar makes decisions that are hard for you to take in. It is hard for you to handle how Caesar is handling certain situations. And right from the get-go in this movie, you can understand why Caesar does certain decisions. He does never feel stupid. He does never feel like he's doing something that doesn't make sense, or it wouldn't make sense for a character in this position. Caesar in this movie is a complete and utter driven ape. He has a purpose in this movie, and he's going full on with that purpose, and that is a very familiar situation, but this time it gets taken from a complete different angle. How the narrative handles its main character and the guide of our story from movie 1 to now movie 3, it is so beautiful and emotionally draining to you as an audience member. If you have followed these characters, if you have liked these characters, it doesn't let up. Every scene in this movie is an emotional punch to the balls, an emotional knife to the stomach, and an emotional poke in the eyes, quite literally. And the directing itself, I mean, how it chooses to tell its story, the visual storytelling in this movie is some of the best this year round. The directing in general by Matt Reeves, every shot in this movie is absolutely immaculate. I was floored and I sank down in my seat because I was just in awe looking at how everything looked pristinely beautiful. Not one thing in a shot seemed like it shouldn't be there. Every bit of gravel, every snowflake, every leaf in the trees was pitch perfect. Every hair on the apes, the special effects, the eyes alone on Andy Serkis, not to mention on the other apes, are so capturing. They capture you so much, and you sink into the mentality of this character, and he guides you through this story that keeps punching you, and you're just there watching and rooting for these characters and this world, and everything that is happening in this movie is earned. I don't say this lightly, but Every single moment in this film, I was hooked. I was captured and immersed in the world that I wanted to be immersed in. But I had my reservations. Every time a new scene started, I was like, all right, movie, earn me back. And it did. Again and again and again. Several times throughout the same scene. Because it keeps elevating and it keeps going in directions that did not seem whatsoever like they were going to go in. And some things that might feel, whoa, like they are a big deal. And then the movie makes a curve and it shows you what it's really about. And you feel a lot of the friendship between the apes and the colony that Caesar started. You have Maurice and Rocket and Luca all with him in this adventure and this journey to saving apekind. And it's just beautiful. It's beautiful. It's perfect. It is masterfully done. And I will talk again about the allegories in this film. They are obvious, but they are so powerful. Imagery, just like in Dawn, that is powerful to a T, that doesn't let up. And the commentary of the movie on that is just as powerful. It takes you for an emotional ride, not only because of what you are witnessing in this film, but also what you've witnessed so far. How does the story overall earn this? You will have to see the movie, but it absolutely fucking does. It's not about war itself and battles, but about the damages of war. Psychological, emotional, physical, on a person, on a society, on a collective of beings that are in this whether they want to or not. It takes a look at the littlest soldier to the biggest man in the hierarchy. And the movie doesn't stop. As I said, emotionally, it doesn't let up, but also, there is one exposition scene in this movie. One. And it's not even in the beginning. The movie in the beginning is full throttle, and then it shows you why it's not about war, really, about battles. And it earns that because of such great character work. Woody Harrelson is not taking shits in this movie. Neither is Caesar. These two characters are perfect mirrors to each other. Broken mirrors, might I add, but they are so well nailed down, and you can see so much of one character in another. I was floored. I am honestly discussing this with myself right now, but War for the Planet of the Apes is fighting with Logan to keep the number one spot as my favorite of the year. It is daunting how much it asks you to take in. It is masterfully done in terms of filmmaking and storytelling in every sense of the word. The acting is fucking flawless. Nominate Andy Serkis for an award, please. And the special effects, of course, are just as nailed down as they were before. They keep getting better and more believable. These are real apes. War for the Planet of the Apes is a true epic narrative. It is the Odyssey and many other classic narratives that you can think of to nail down a trilogy, to put this as one of the best trilogies of all time. It is with utter honesty that I tell you that this is a genuine work of art. A perfect blending of summer blockbuster and thinking man's sci-fi that will be talked about years to come. This is one of the best movies of the year, and probably of the last 10 years, because War for the Planet of the Apes is the stuff that dreams are made of. What did you think of War for the Planet of the Apes, my beautiful geekies? Are you still drying up your tears? I sure am. Let me know in the comments below what is your favorite of the three movies. If you've seen all three, if you have not, let me know what is your favorite between Rise and Dawn, and I can't wait to know your thoughts about War. I have a very special video tomorrow for you guys, and once more, thank you so much for watching. You guys are the freaking best. We are now 1,000, and I can't believe it, and I'll talk about it tomorrow, but thank you guys. You are the freaking best forever. So until tomorrow with a very special video, you stay beautiful, you stay geeky, and if you haven't done so yet, click the subscribe button and the bell so we can be geeky united!